गुड मॉर्निंग टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू टेक यू हाउ द रिविजन पावर ऑफ द हाई कोर्ट इज रिस्ट्रिक्टेड द हाउ द हेरिडिटरी मुतावली इज बीइंग अपॉइंटेड हाउ द कस्टमरी राइट्स आर बीइंग क्लेम्ड विदाउट इंटरप्शन how Indian Evidence Act section 35 45 are being taken into consideration and if you this may be a case of a Muslim field of law but still you can if you follow the judgment you can understand so many aspects wherein you can learn more things to apply the judgment and these concepts enriched in this judgment in other field also and particularly the Tharwar and so many other sect of Hindus which are stated in Hindu Succession Act may also be understood. Kindly go through the judgment running lot of pages. Of course, AR 2020 Supreme Court 2992 Aliya Tamuda Vita Biya Pura Pukaya and another Pattakkal Cheriya Koya and others. This case arises from Andaman and Lakshadweep Union Territory. Therefore, jurisdiction is Kerala High Court. They have discussed Section 115, Revision Power and Civil Procedure, Section 83, 9, 69, 2 of Waqf Act, then about Muthawali, then Qazis Act, 12 of 1818, then Order 23, Rule 3, and Order 1, Rule 8, how the compromise degree is being given effective, Section 35, 45 and 81 of Indian Evidence Act, then all these cases were, provisions were discussed. The appeal was arised out of the CRP by the input judgment of Kerala High Court, decreeing the one suit and decreeing the other suit, allowing a Muthawali by succession and dismissing the other person's claim. This is about Unroad Juma Mosque situated in Lakshadweep. Though it is called Lakshadweep, in Tamil it is called Lakshadweep. Lax means it's not lax islands were available. It was purchased from a Muslim for 1 lakh rupees. Therefore, it was called as Lakshadweep. They say Tawaris branches of descendants through female line. Pattakkal family. This is what they have said. Aliya Tamuda Tawad claims. So, the Tawad family has been discussed in the Indian Succession Act also. So, you should hear what had actually happened. So many concepts were introduced here in this case, wherein though the Muthawali Nama did not disclose about hereditary Muthawalyship, but however it was being followed from long years. Therefore, the Supreme Court and as well as other courts held that the Muthawali by hereditary is customary rights, and in between there was some committee appointed under Qazi Act to supervise the functions of the Muthawali. The Supreme Court has held that this intervention is not intervention to the customary practice, because the said Qazi did not manage the mosque but only supervise the mosque. Therefore, they have held in that way. So you kindly go through the judgment deeply, and several paragraphs are most important. Then they say, under section 81 of the Evidence Act, the gazette of an official gazette is a public affairs. Genuine is presumed under section 81 of the Indian Evidence Act. Under 35, entry made by the gazetteer in discharge of his official is a relevant fact. Then the fact recorded by the gazetteer may also be considered as an expert opinion under section 45 of the Evidence Act. So all this would also help you if you refer this concept in other matter also, apart from this Muslim case law which was before the Supreme Court. Then the claim of the appellants that there was intervening period between the mutawallis, therefore the customary rights may not be applicable, but that was overruled by the Supreme Court. Then you have to read paragraph 18 of the judgment, wherein hereditary rights citations were discussed by giving so many examples. Therefore, whenever you if you have a CBI Hindu cases for hereditaryship, you can refer this case for claiming hereditaryship. Then they have also discussed about Mohammedan law by Faiz, then Tahir Mohammed editions, and also S.A. Qadar, our S.A. Qadar judgment also, his book on Muslim law also been discussed. Then that's why in the appointment of Qazi in 1998 was also not considered by the Supreme Court under Qazi, 4C of the Qazi's Act. They have referred some Hindu cases also while deciding these issues. K.S. Srinivas Iyengar as Ramanujacharya case, where customary titles were claimed. Then they have discussed about Order 23 Rule 3B, while compromising the degree dated zones are merely procedural and do not vitiate the degree. Violation of Order 23 Rule 3B, while compromise, that is only they say, only violation of procedure and do not vitiate the degree. Then they say Order 23 Rule 3B cannot set to merely procedure and to go to the root of the matter, since they deprive the affected parties of the chance to question the term of compromise that they are going to be bound by, since the both conditions were not complied, the compromise degree was void. This was the final ratio held by the Supreme Court. Finally, they allowed, stating that respondents have been able to establish a customary right to the office of Mutawali of the Juma Mosque, and therefore they have upheld the revision power. And so far revision powers are concerned, the Supreme Court has held at so many paragraphs that if the evidences are perused by the lower court improperly, inconsistent with the records on record, then the revision court can interfere with such findings and revise the order of the lower court. That was the power of the revision was discussed. Therefore, go through this judgment for those who are aspiring for district judges and district municipal court. So my humble request to the honorable judges, bar council members, and the advocate association leading office bearers to pursue the honorable high court judicature, to allow us by fixing time by time to perform puja of chamber that will deconcentrate our mind for a long years. Kindly do the needful. I pray all of you may definitely get some interference of favor in this regulation, distances.